Hi, I'm Emma. Did you know that according to a new Gallup study, 85% of teachers who focus on creativity and learning and use technology in transformative ways say they often see their students engaging in problem solving? Creativity is necessary to integrate in the classroom because it results in skills such as problem solving, critical thinking, and having a deep understanding of the subject matter. Herbert Simon, a pioneer in cognitive science, classified problems as well-structured, semi-structured, and ill-structured. Well-structured problems are usually routine and repetitive, and usually they can be solved using straightforward decision aids. Very little creativity is needed. Ill-structured problems are characterized by a lack of good information about the problem and fuzziness about the present and desired state of the affairs. Little or no information is available on how to solve the problem. One often muddles through to a solution. A large amount of creativity is needed to address such problems. Creativity isn't often thought of as an extremely important skill. However, creative thinking often brings the solutions and the solution methods that would not normally work. Creative thinking means looking for important connections by creating several original, new, and wacky possibilities, as well as building on prior possibilities. Critical thinking means looking at possibilities through a careful, fair, and constructive lens. You then have to rank those priorities and make an informed choice. Effective problem solvers must think both creatively and critically, making many options and then focusing on a specific one. We must find a balance. Successful problem solvers find a balance and use critical thinking to do so. When students are stimulated creatively, where they're asked to problem solve, brainstorm, create, invent, act, you get the point. They have higher chances of remembering the subject matter and retaining what they've learned. Parents, how many one woman / one man plays or songs did your child come up with when they were younger? That same drive to create still exists. We just want to manifest it in a way that'll impact their academic future. There are a few ways we can practice creativity in the classroom so we can hone in on our problem-solving skills, our ways to think critically and creatively, and our ability to retain information. The first one is brainstorming. An aspect of creativity is generating many varied, unusual options for an open-ended task or a question. Another one is force fitting. That is when we connect two things that have nothing to do with each other, but somehow we find a connection and we create new possibilities inside that connection. Another strategy is refining and developing. That is using a very deliberate, constructive approach to strengthen or improve our options by considering the advantages, limitations, also ways to overcome those, and a unique feature. Scamper is applying a checklist of action words or phrases, like idea-spurring questions, to evoke or trigger new or varied possibilities. The last is morphological matrix. So that is identifying the key parameters of a task, generating possibilities for each one of those parameters, and then investigating the possible combinations between parameters. So we're really mixing and matching our ideas. Now we can take the ideas that we've generated and turn those into designs or practical uses. So we can use websites like Voki, Canva, PowerPoint, Word, Flipgrid, Prezi, any of that to get our ideas across, or we can build a physical model of our idea. In conclusion, students need both content knowledge and skills to apply and transform their knowledge for useful and creative purposes and to keep learning as content and circumstances change. We need to stimulate creativity in the classroom because creative skills are needed in every single job market and will be useful in every single opportunity that they are given.